Warning, adventure activities can be extremely dangerous. Please use extreme caution when out in the elements, and if you should go, ask your mom. Now, go out and in.
Jay Shrek.
James.
You know, we've got a fabulous show today. We're in an historical location called Oatman Point. Now, if you're familiar with Oatman Point, you might be familiar with the Oatman family, who didn't fare as well here. But it's not just the Oatman Massacre site that we're here. There's a lot of things to see. We have the massacre site, but we also have the trail that goes into the valley. We're going to be looking for geoglyphs. Some people call them intaglios, but they're going to be markings on the ground that you're only going to be able to see from the sky, which is unbelievable in itself. So you're not going to want to miss this show because it's not just one thing, it's a whole plethora of things. February 18th, 1851. A tragedy happened on this very hill with the Oatman family. Now, we're not going to get into that on this one. If you look at the link above, you're going to be able to go and see the entire Oatman story, but that's just one small part of what we're here going to do here today. So let's get started. The first thing I want to show you is right down here. Now, if you can picture this valley in 1851, you can see that wagon train that took most of the day to come up this hill. And you also can imagine the Mormon battalion coming up this hill. Now, what's just fascinating about this is that you can still see the grooves in the rock of this treacherous uphill battle that took place for those to get the wagon trains out of the river basin up to the top of the plateau. It's fabulous. These are still here. You can feel the history. You can feel the history right here. And you can also feel the dread of the fateful day of what happened on the very top of that hill. But it's not just one place. There's this is filled with history. You know, as you hike halfway out of the ramp coming from the river to the mesa, you're gonna look to the north, and there are petroglyphs even right here. Some really neat petroglyphs on that treacherous hill right there that I didn't even know existed. So if you take your time, what you're going to find out is this location is absolutely intriguing. Now, one of the big gems for me is finding the geoglyphs. That's the jewel of this journey today. Come on along, because what I want to show you is this. What are we looking for? We are looking for geometric lines and figures that have been scratched into the ground so the gods above could see. Now, they're difficult to find, and the problem in Arizona is a lot of times vehicles drive over them not even knowing that they're there, because you got to remember, this is a pattern that's drawn on the ground that's only viewable from above. And so people drive across these areas not even knowing that they're driving over priceless artifacts. But they're incredible to see, and once you saw one, you want to find more. You know, the first thing we came across as we're skating across these two mesas is this rock cropping. Now, this could have been a blind, but it's definitely of the era. It really is an old structure. Again, it could have been a hunting blind. It could have been just a rock shelter. But we know they're all over this area. So I'm not surprised, are you, James, that we would find petroglyphs all along this bank, even if we're not finding them in groupings. You know, we see sporadic petroglyphs all over this area.
Yes, definitely.
The moon here. You know, at first all this is mysterious, but then it becomes actually kind of calculated, doesn't it? You start realizing, okay, This is where they put these. This is how they put these. And so you start following the river and it all starts to make sense. Now, I don't know why, but that's just the way it is. So you start to look at places, you go, okay, now common sense tells me that it's going to be on that point. It's going to be around the corner because it's always around the corner. It always, on those peaks, the sun coming across, it always seems to be on the backside. So like right there, I'd say the petroglyphs on that point there are right around that corner. And I guarantee you we're going to see a bunch of them. We're going to find a bunch of them over there. Yeah, a lot of times what they're not reinventing the wheel. Nobody is. If a spot was laid there for Indians 1,000 years ago, then a rancher or a cowboy does the same thing, or somebody on a Mormon battalion does the same thing. You know, so they didn't reinvent the wheel. That's what's kind of cool is, you know, they find a spot that probably fires have been there for 1,000 years. They use the same spot because it wasn't just automatic that all of a sudden you have this dry, bare spot. Somebody manipulated this to some degree. You know, as you sit here, you wonder about the amount of campfires we're here. You know, you go to a point where you think, it's new. But the reality of this fire pit could have been here for 1,000 years. And why wouldn't it have been? It's on the top of a mesa. It goes down to the river. It could be here forever. You know, another thing we've looked at is, you know, we've not seen any fish petroglyphs. What's the scoop with that? Why aren't there any fish petroglyphs? That I don't know. I'm as confused with that as maybe anybody is. But I can imagine everywhere from 1,000-year-old ancients to the Mormon battalion could have been sitting on this very hill, cooking their food and staying warm. You know, when I stand at a location like this, you ever wonder what it's like, what it was like to be here at that day, at that specific time, and see the events that changed a whole entire family's lives? You ever think about that? You know, why did they just walk away from those Indians that actually clubbed them? They didn't shoot them, they actually clubbed the family to death. You know, why didn't they shoot them? Do you ever wonder that? One thing that I want to find more than probably anything in this whole Gila Valley is Kit Carson wrote his name on a wall on Freedom Point. I would love to find that. That would be like the ultimate to me. So what year does something become not graffiti and somebody doing something illegal? Because it seems funny when I see them in 1800s, guess what? That's pretty cool. But when they're 1970s, that sucks, right? Why? What is that? Okay. Hey, James.
All right.
This is it. I think this is just another section of them.
Oh, yeah, that guy's got tools.
He does have tools. He definitely looks like he has tools. You know, I don't know if this is just the rock being a little different or they're as old as they look. This looks like some of the oldest stuff. I don't know that it is, but it looks like. I see him crawl all the way across that.
These. In our search for Oatman Point, we've gone in a direction we weren't expecting to.
I'd have been mad if we'd got over there.
Found a solid panel all the way along the opposite side of what we were thinking to be looking for.
What? Down here below you. Yes.
Okay. Over here. Unbelievable.
You see from up there?
Not very well, but I can see them.
They're below us or below you?
No, they're farther down.
Okay, cool. Okay, good. Pretty interesting, yeah.
This still looks very rudimentary. I mean, comparatively to what we've been seeing.
Well.
That's a nice panel right there. I don't know what this tall cat here is.
it?
Yeah. This whole wall's done.
Yeah, I know it. I can't get to it.
Oh, those are ancient. These look really old. These look like really old.
Big squarish one?
Down there, the big one.
Right here? It looks like a vulture.
The big one on the wall in the sun.
I think they're deers. Man, either these washed off or they're older than anything we've seen. Oh, I can go all the way. This is a good panel right here. It's got the big, all kinds of animals.
Yeah. Did you look down here, dude?
Well, not yet. Is it?
Well, crevice all the way back. There's glyphs that go down into this. That'll tell you they're old, because those have the same kind of wear.
Oh, look at that.
Exactly.
Look at all this on the top.
Exactly.
These boys have wood.
Oh, yeah. Oh, this is bizarre. John, come over here. I want to show you this. James found this. See right here. There's petroglyphs in this. So this wall and here, but it's in here between these two rocks. They actually got in here and actually carved stuff in here, which is like crazy.
Wild, huh?
I can overthrow.
Because it's like, who were they expecting to see this?
I don't think anybody.
Do you believe that it's a spiritual thing?
There's shit under here. Look at this.
Oh, yeah.
There's stuff all over. This definitely looks old. It definitely doesn't have the same. There's a couple animals that look the same, but like those big deer with the kind of shaded. Now, we've seen that before.
Yep.
But this is old stuff. That's what my gut tells me, whether it's true or not. You know what I think?
Huh.
I think.
No, I mean, we kind of need that. That's how this whole thing works. Well, that means we'll actually go check the other side.
Yeah, because I, you know.
If you go with me, we just stay here and we miss something possibly.
Well, or if you go with me, then we miss this.
Yeah, well, that's what I mean. That's why this is perfect.
There's a pretty wild one in front of you from the sun facing you, but you might have to walk around that one in front of you to see it.
John guiding us from above. I like it.
It's so big, I can't get it all.
I get that a lot. I get that a lot. I'm a humanitarian.
Are you guys making fun of me?
No.
Okay.
I'm making fun of me. Well, not really. I'm really enhancing me. I guess that's not making fun of me.
I'm saying we've added a whole new element to exploring because we got a spotter above.
We got a spotter.
So usually we're doing part of this blind. And we go places we don't need to go, or we miss places we should have go.
As soon as you go around the corner there, you're going to see one on your left. Right
there. Oh yeah, look at that guy. What the heck is that?
That's a whip it good.
Dude.
I don't even know what the hell that is.
There, that's a...
That's a guy, it looks like a guy strung up between two wires. See him on the right side?
On the far right there, it looks like a guy hanging kind of?
Yeah, kind of like both of
them. Ow. Oh, that is interesting. What the heck is that?
I'm not even sure
that
what
that looks like. A Da Vinci contraption.
It does look like a good Da Vinci contraption. And they go all the way around this point. They're down below too, James.
Yeah.
There's a whole nother level down here.
What is that, dude?
I don't know. That's a freaky
that's
McFreaky.
One of the weirdest ones.
I think that's the invention of S&M.
The beginnings of some...
ancient deer leather. What the hell do I do with my... I don't want my trash down here. What do I do with it?
There's stuff all over down here, man.
Oh, and it goes all the way down, too. It's not just... It goes down to those points down here.
Well, no, that's why I know we got to go down, because I'm sure we're going to see some hummingbird-like stuff where the big prominent one's telling you to... Because right now we're seeing the, like... It's weird how they did this shit, but it's starting to make sense that you know you got to look down after you do the top. Keep going.
Oh, yeah, I see it all the way around that point. Well, I got to think that this is Oatman's Point, but if it is, then there's going to be geoglyphs on the top.
And there should be stuff up above.
Yes.
Well, we have an option to pop out. Do you want to pop out, look up, and then come back down?
No, let's just keep do working. It while we're down.
Yeah, that works for me, too. This area gets enough water with grass. Don't touch that. Cloud.
These look a little deeper down here.
Yeah, these are more defined.
Hey, John! John! He can come in here.
Yeah, well, that's what I was going to suggest if he really wants to get up and close.
You can come in down here and look at these. There's trail. Come over there.
Come down there?
Yeah, because I think there's a little trail. You can see these right here.
Compass.
This has got to be Oatman. I mean, it has to be.
Yeah, I feel it. My gut tells me we're at Oatman. Big hand, big feet, hook nose. Or like cane head. That would be a better description of him.
Here's a big man. Well, see, here's what's funny, okay? Here's what's funny to me. Okay, so why do we see this at Agua Fria? Why do we see it all over the valley? Why do we also see it at Agua Fria? There's big hands, big feet, right? Uh-huh. Basically the same guy, right? So why would they envision themselves from two different locations looking the same, right? Unless they had been traveling back and forth for up and down this Gila Bend and Gila River Bend forever, right? I mean, you know.
Well, we know that, you know? Like, I mean, definitely know that if you were at Agua Fria.
Look at that. Is that guy riding that?
I can't tell.
See him here?
I see it. I just can't see if it's a riding situation.
There's a guy. There's something.
There's an animal, for
and
sure.
And then that looks like a guy.
Well, there's something that spurts out of that big sun-type shape right there, too. On both ends of it. And then here's another one of those.
Yeah, that's a cool, weird little design.
Look at this thing.
I like this this triangle, too. This is pretty cool.
Quite a place.
Well, it because it's just different completely too. The rocks are different, the feel's different, the style's different. I mean, everything's different. And then here you can get right in too.
Yeah, I mean, the problem is this kid. Oh,
I figured you'd want to see this though.
I can haul your camera out for you. If we need to.
Look at that.
I can make it happen safely.
Oh,
there's some more of your Picasso.
It's not as good as that one though, man. That one is
actually,
like,
you know what, that looks like Matisse's work.
You know, I don't even remember seeing pictures of this.
Well, here's the deal. I don't think there is. I mean, I think that with this, one thing about what we're doing is, you know, there might be a handful here or there, but like that, I've never seen this wall here. That's really unique. I've never seen that kind of snake design.
Yeah.
Just like down there, there's those diamonds. I've never seen that either.
Shaded snakes, yeah.
And then you come over here to where this is kind of abstract modern, and then you go to the next panel and it's like rudimentary, right? You know, it's like more Cro-Magnon.
Are they all the way around?
It appears
there's some here, but not a lot.
It appears that it's slowing up a little. Look at those. Again.
Those look old. And then there's more down here. There's a sundown.
Yeah, that's it. It's picking up again. So.
It's a weird.
Here, I'm going to shoot it because I can't read it, but maybe we can go over it later.
Hell, there's shit down there even.
Oh, there's stuff all over, dude.
Hell, I just saw a panel down there I didn't see. You know, it's amazing you still find pottery on the ground if you're really looking. And then here's another piece too. Now the funny thing is, these don't look like the same pieces, and that's old stuff right there. That's colonial stuff. That's way old. See how that, how almost you have the almost the pattern right in it, and the old, newer stuff's got that more modern smoothness. But somebody missed that. Somebody dropped a pot out here somewhere. It's amazing what you still can find. So you leave it alone, and you know what? If you can find it too, that's awesome. You know, I tell you, we definitely saw a lot of geoglyphs all along this area. You see these trails that maybe look like car tracks, and all of a sudden there is one and it goes to the left or the right. There's definitely geometric shapes out here. You know, God only knows what they mean, but they're out here. So if you're out here in your vehicle, make sure that you watch out where you're going when you're in this area, anywhere out here, because you can run over this stuff, and it's pretty cool. We don't know what any of them means, but we'll try to get some of the footage back from the drone. Hopefully that worked. It didn't want to fly as high as we wanted it to, but we'll just have to replace it and get something that works better, James. I think it's funny that that thing says that over the cliff of the petroglyphs or the geoglyphs is the, so that means there's more over there we just didn't really
That's
see.
What I would think. We were just focused on something else. Or they've been, because over at Oatman, maybe, I don't know. I mean, that's a heavily trafficked thing, so I don't know. These are referred to as fragile pattern zones, according to the archaeological paper that we have about this particular area. So, tread lightly out here, please.
Pretty incredible. They just spend
it really
their
is,
they spend their time here making these designs for the thunder gods.
I would think that must be the expectation. Cool side note: we did see for the first time like a whole chunk of pottery out here on the ground. It's a pretty remote spot, so it makes sense.